And we are off. This is the Minish Cap Randomizer weekly race. Today we are playing under race settings, which is Open Fusions, Rupee Mania, and Traps Are On. Should be a good race. Good luck to everyone involved. I am excited to see how I stack up against some of the other players. As the tournament will be starting this week, I believe. Starting off with bombs, that is good. We can do Minish Loop very early. Like, I'm probably gonna go straight to Minish Loop right after I hit up this cave. Not a ton of things in here, but I'll take some health. Health is good. I would like some more consistent ways of getting through things. Lots of health early on. Very interesting. There's our first trap. And it's an enemy trap. So it spawned an enemy. And we got a bottle. Okay. Very interesting start. We still don't have access to Krennel, but like one item will get us access. Like Caper Flippers will get us access to Krennel. But yeah, right now, Minish Loop is definitely the play. Like, anytime you get early bombs, going through the full Minish Loop makes sense. Because there's a sword. Alright. We still don't have Spin. Spin will get us into Krennel now. More hearts. This is a very healthy seed already. I also have not done a map check, so we don't know if Deepwood is required. Doesn't matter right now because we can't get into Deepwood. But that is going to be good knowledge later on. I'll do a map check after I leave Minish Woods, I think. Oh, I forgot to check what the visible spot was. I'm gonna check it now. It was nothing, okay. Other than the sword, not a lot over here. We got sword, we got bottle. And that's about it. Still... Oh! Oh, there's another sword. That is very good info. So Flipper's cape would get us another sword. Very valuable information there. I still think going Tingle Trees is probably the best play right here. But I will open up the pathway here. Got a butterfly. And a kinstone. Okay, that is a caster stone. Now is a good time for us to figure out what is required. Okay. No crypt, no cave of flames. So all kinstones are required. Yeah, that's a little unfortunate because we're getting a lot of things that are going to let us go to Cave of Flames. Like, go up to Krennel, Cave of Flames area. Oh, there's a cape! Okay. So, cape. That opens up a lot. I think we're going to go straight to Krennel. Or wait, we can get that sword. I think let's just check out Krennel real quick. And then head back and get that sword. I feel like just doing lower Krennel is going to be okay. Yo, Sigma with the tier 1 sub. Really appreciate it. Thanks a lot. Welcome to the button mashies. So I know this is probably like a bad play-ish, but considering that Cave of Flames is not required, I think this is an okay play. We're going to take out the bulk of what's available in Krennel and potentially not have to come back here. Also, with cape, it lets me skip a cave. Cape also lets me save a bunch of bombs here. Second butterfly already. Not bad. I believe it was rolled by Nessman. Got ourselves a boomerang. I'll take it. So after this, we're immediately going for that sword. I might grab like one or two things on the way. Probably stop in town and grab a few things along the way. But I want that sword for sure. I pressed it once. That was dumb. I can still get one more item here. It's not a big deal. After this, we are definitely getting that sword. More health! Oh, that's in the speedrun route, so yeah. A lot of people know about that. I can get what, two? Yeah, I can get two. Push this for now, so I don't forget to do it later. Nothing in the shop, that's good. Juliet's house has nothing as well. That's also good. Yeah, I know. There's a lot of alternate strats for things. A bow. Interesting. Nothing there. We'll check out Goron Cave and then head to Lake Hylia. I think we might want to go straight into Temple Droplets. We'll see what else we get along the way, but I think Temple Droplets is our play. At the very least, we are unlocking areas, unlocking shortcuts, stuff like that. Outside is nothing. Yeah, we're going into Temple Droplets. I might as well at least get the like first Rupee Mania area. Okay, that's nothing. Yeah, the heart color is kind of annoying. Cause you can't really see what the hearts are, because they're the similar shade of gray. But I can kinda tell.
I'm Batman.
Link's Batman. Alright, what do we got here? This is all we can get. We got a key. We got a kinstone. And another key. Alright. So I'm gonna save. And we're actually going to do top left. Since I have keys, we're gonna do top left right now. This doesn't pay off. Well then I'll just save scum it. I'm really bad. There we go. That's the pattern I'm supposed to do. I forgot how to do this puzzle. Cause it's been a while since I've done it. And it's just bombs. Okay. So we don't need that. That saves us a key. Alright, I gotta remember, like, how to maneuver around here. Reset is A, B, start, select. Okay. That is interesting. We don't have spin yet. We still don't have spin. But that is very interesting. I think our next play is to go back to town. We gotta do town stuff. There's not that many other things we can do. Yeah, I could do Simon. There's a couple town things we can do. We just need spin. I can do well. I can do town Minish. There's a lot of things. Pretty much everything is randomized. Trying to think if there's anything that's not explicitly randomized. The elements are not randomized. So you have to actually complete dungeons in order to get the elements. Oh, come on. This is a bad chickens. Where did the final chicken go? Where did it go? I actually don't know where it went. It went up there? How did it get up there? Alright, we can do this. Stop getting in my way! Where is it now? There it is. Okay. I was gonna say. I knew it, dude! I knew it! Spin on chickens. I knew it was worth doing chickens. Actually, it's gonna be faster for me to quick warp here. I feel bad for the people that are not gonna do chickens. I mean, there's not that many other things to do, but still, not doing chickens. Going to hurt. Now the next big thing is, where is our lamp? Because that's going to let us finish Todd. Oh man. Oh man. What is this? What is this? I don't even know what I just got. I got like 500 things. Obscure locations, there's like some weird spots, like underwater rupee spots and stuff that no one really knows where they are. At least I don't. Yeah, as part of the Rupee Mania setting, anything that is a rupee spot is now randomized. Except for like obscure location rupees. So the beanstalks are huge. They have a ton of items, generally. Oh, I already have all three caster kinstones, so we can go straight to fortress. Probably gonna do that right after I check this. We're just gonna check a few things here. Dog food, okay. I'll take it. I have what, 5 scrolls? Okay. So I can't do this just yet. It's fine. Not planning on doing it right now. Can't believe I already have fortress access. I'm not going to be able to beat Fortress, but I have access. And there's a lot of items in Fortress. And I don't really have a lot of other things I can do. There's a few things I can do in town. But for the most part, this is our best play. Ocarina, I'll definitely take that. Oh, that is big. That is a big item. And we got the Veil Falls Kinstone! Give me a grip ring, and we're in business. But no, give me the mids first. Give me the mids so I can finish this dungeon. And then give me the grip ring. Shout out to Great Spin. Great Spin is amazing. No, I didn't get Rockbreaker and all that. I had to test it just to make sure. Like I just got so many scrolls, I did not know what I got. Alright, so I'm gonna check the Minish checks first. And that's simply because I have that feeling. I have that feeling that the Minish checks are gonna have something. Whether it's like mole mids or grip ring or something. Something that will be useful. Okay. That's fine. I can't see what that is. That's a key there. Now have enough for Waveblade already. That's kind of insane. What would be the worst case for an item in a race? Anything that requires going into Dark Hyrule Castle to get an item from there, and then having to go into a dungeon to get the four sword or something, or like get the gust jar or something that is required, but like you don't need it for the dungeons you need to do. We do need the gust jar because we do need to beat Deepwood, so that is guaranteed. We need that before going into Dark Hyrule Castle. But sometimes there might be an item like that. Jabbernut after flippers is just useless. That's not really a worst case scenario. It's just, you're not gonna use it. Because you already have access to Deep Wood at that point. We got him! Aww, I was expecting that to actually be a book. There's a Gust Jar. Okay. Now that Gust Jar is interesting. We're getting some items here. Just not the ones we need in order to beat this dungeon. Alright, that's a map. I think I have... Yeah, I have one more check I can do. Or two. Two more. I can do clone puzzle. I guess technically I can get vanilla flippers? Or no, vanilla mitts? Yeah, vanilla mitts is a thing that I could possibly do. Depends on what we get here. If we get a key... Alright. I think I'm gonna save and then quick warp. I don't know. I don't know if I needed to save. Yeah, I probably didn't need to save there. Because we're gonna want this door open anyway, I think. Because we get the mini boss portal at least. Like, we'll have the mini-boss portal, and then, vanilla mitts. We'll get this vanilla mitts chest, and then we're gonna leave. Okay, we're keeping that. This is interesting now. Very interesting. I think we immediately turn in that. Immediately. Also, now that we have Great Spin, I'm not opposed to doing Simon, since we're here. What is the seed, dude? What is the seed? Yeah, I think we go Lake Hylia. There's a couple things we can do in Lake Hylia. I like the idea of just doing the library right away. Oh my god! What is the seed, dude? This is insane. This is actually an insane seed. Alright, we're going straight. Straight up the Veil Falls. I know it's probably a bad idea because we do not have the lantern yet. And technically all this is lantern locked. But come on, there's just too many items. And no one uses the lantern to get here anyway. Grippering was at Librari. So yeah, this is certainly a seed. The only thing is, lantern cannot be up here, but we can find basically everything else. And I'm fine with at least getting the crest. It can't be up here. This is logically locked by the lantern because of that first dark cave. Even though everyone just goes through it in the dark anyway. All right. I think the big play right here is Krennel Beanstalk. Krennel Beanstalk and then maybe even vanilla Cave of Flames entrance. I doubt it, but Krennel Beanstalk is big. We'll also get the three checks in here as well. Okay, we'll do Beanstalk, then Temple Droplets. Unless we get... No, yeah, that's the play. We still can't get into Deepwood. We still don't have Nut or Flippers. Hopefully, we get one of those soon. Then we can do Deepwood and Temple Droplets, but as of right now, the play is Temple Droplets. Oh, what? We have... Oh, I was gonna say. Dude, imagine. Imagine if we had four sword. Well, the reason why, I think, is the bomb upgrades are coded differently than regular items. It might be possible, but I don't know. So what, that's two books? That's two books. We're at two books already. We just need Kane? Kane in another book, and that opens up Yulari. There's Kate. What is going on, dude? This seed. No, we're not going Cave of Flames. Cave of Flames is not a dungeon we want to go to. I mean, we could go there if we run out of other things to do. Do I have map and compass? I just have compass. But what Kane does provide for us is the opportunity to go into school and school garden. still didn't pick up Rock Breaker. That's fine. Don't really care too much right now. This is looking like a pretty good seed overall. The biggest thing is going to be, where are our mitts and our force word? Alright, that is all keys. Ideally, we find mitts in here. That would be probably the most ideal thing. We find mitts in here, we do fortress, we do hype cave. Let's do some of this. So hopefully, we end up finding some good items here. Nothing good there. Okay. So we're probably gonna have to... Probably gonna have to check everything else. Which isn't terrible. My biggest concern is that the underwater pot is going to have something. Okay. Usually doesn't happen to me. There we go. Oh man, okay, good. You got me while I was still on fire. Ugh. Oh, this is also something to note. This is out of logic, technically. Like, Octo is out of logic right now, because we do not have flippers. But I'll still do it anyway. Because I can. It just means flippers are not going to be locked behind anything that Octo has to offer. Thank you. There we go. Because this jump right here is... not in logic anymore. It used to be. Now it's not. So we are still going to finish off Octo. I'll probably come back in and get a couple more checks. We are able to get 1, 2, 3, 4 more checks after this. Aside from Blue Chew, which I'm not going to do unless I absolutely have to. Though, based on how this seed has been going, all the weird checks are turning up with good items, so... maybe Blue Chew has something. But I still don't want to do Blue Chew. We have the means of doing Blue Chew right now. I just don't want to do it. I miss. That was bad. There we go. I mean, it's still okay. Almost guaranteed. Oh! Oh! It didn't work. Okay, we got him. We got him with a zero ink still. That's pretty good. I'll definitely take it. Really bad walk, though. Alright, so we still have a few more checks we can get in here. Gonna grab them before we leave. Alright, so after this, we have one more check we can do. And then I gotta start thinking of other places to go. Is an interesting idea because we got cane. Other cane spots are probably going to be also very good as well. This has been a very bad matter pillar fight. Okay. Yeah, let's do cane stuff right now. There is... You know what? It's probably faster to just do that. We can do Lower Veil Falls. Oh, we can do Lon Lon. Don't forget Lon Lon. Okay. Jabbernut. That is deep wood access. So now all of a sudden we go deep wood. So this was Lantern / Gust Locked. That's good to know. Boss key is behind Matter Pillar. Also, no keys so far. That's telling me vanilla, or not vanilla route, but we're gonna have to go and take the lily pad. We absolutely have to take the lily pad. Thank you. Alright, there's a key. What I'm probably gonna end up doing is going all the way and then coming back to do boss key chest. Yeah, we're gonna end up doing boss key chest, and then we'll come back and do everything else later. Because I think at this point, either A, Green Shoe has a key, or B, there's a key on the, I forget what their name is, but where the first key normally is. I think guaranteed this has to be an item. Yeah. That's an item. There is still a key out there. So unless the key is here, we're done. Alright, what's gonna be on the heart container spot? It's the key, okay. So we're gonna have to come back in and get that one last check. Because that is gonna be an item. Yeah, it's an item. I was just double checking and make sure it wasn't like a Oh, wait. Why is it like that? Oh no, that's not the one. That's not the button I wanted. Alright. I guess I have to leave and come back in. To reset the barrel. Yeah, okay. It's the bow upgrade, okay. Not terrible, but not exactly what we're looking for. Now I gotta really start thinking about what places do I want to go? And I think part of that is we still have a lot of things that we can check with the cane. We really didn't do much. We actually didn't even do any cane checks. The Jabbernut wasn't a cane check. Like I was going to do earlier, we're going to Lower Veil Falls. Can get a couple quick checks here. There's Rockbreaker. Okay. And now... now I think we start doing some town checks. There's a lot of town checks we can do. Visible spot is nothing. Okay. You know what? I don't want to do that right now. Because I don't have moments, so I can't get the middle check. With Kane, though, Town Minish sounds okay. Right now, we're just left looking for items. We gotta figure out where we wanna go. Cave of Flames might actually be a decent play. Thank you. Yeah, I think if town checks don't pay off... Yeah, I think we go Cave of Flames now. If that was possible, that would be insane. Like, just cross Zelda randos. Sometimes you just gotta make a bold play and go for a non-required dungeon. Sometimes that bold play does not pay off. Alright, we don't need to open the door for the heart piece slot. Already found map and compass. So far, this dip has not paid off. But sometimes you gotta be in it for the long game. This could be a Malari seed. Oh! We had to come in here anyway. There is a kinstone. So this did pay off. Okay. I'm gonna complete this dungeon. I'm gonna complete it at this point. Just in case our final kinstone or our moments end up here. But chances are our final kinstone is gonna be in Cloud Tops. Moments could be around there too. But I've gotta be thorough now. Flippers. Ooh. Oh, Flippers is interesting. Flippers caves. M- Minish flippers checks are big. Yeah, this ended up being a pretty decent Cave of Flames. Sometimes you just have to go for the that non-required dungeon. Yeah, flippers are here. And that makes things a little bit more interesting. Because that gives me a lot more checks that I can do before going up to Cloud Tops. I definitely want to do Minish Flippers checks. Like, that cave is a gold mine. I definitely want to do that before heading up there. Yeah, there's definitely that possibility of Mitz being flipper locked. Remote bombs, not bad. I will definitely take that if I have to find... If I have to come in here, I'll definitely take remote bombs. Yeah, I need bomb bags. That's what I really need. Playing through this entire seed with a generic 10 bomb bag. We do have Boaterfly. I could go for the butterfly strats here. Alright. So that's Cave of Flames down. We'll do Malari, and then we will head to Minish Flippers checks. So those were the only things in there. But Malari is something you can only get after completing Cave of Flames. So let's see what we get. It's nothing. Okay. Minish Flipper checks are a big deal. A lot of times these end up having some good items in. Sometimes there's nothing, but this is a good set of checks to do. There's a bomb bag. We can use that. Also, I think that's bottle percent. No, it's not bottle percent. Okay. I need one more for bottle percent. Now I think we do the Cloud Tops check. We've got a decent amount of things. We can check most of Cloud Tops. We have 4 kinstones. We're gonna have to do this eventually, so I might as well do it now. Biggest issue right now is we do not have the moments. So there's a couple checks we cannot do right now, but we can make it work. We can definitely work with what we have. Oh, wait. I didn't realize that that happened. Whatever. I didn't realize you could get stuck there. I mean, that's good to know, right? Can't get that. Alright, there's only one more check we can get while we're up here. And then we're gonna have to go elsewhere. Are you kidding me, dude? The wallet doesn't matter. Wait, oh, I fall down here. Yeah, I fall down there. Alright, so we gotta find either one more kinstone or we gotta find molmits, something. Looks like placing that kinstone screwed up the tracking for kinstones. Doesn't make a difference. I know I need one more kinstone. There's the molmits. Okay. That's big. We're going straight back to Fort. Actually, no. Let's do Hype Cave. Let's do Hype Cave first. And then we'll go straight to Fortress. Because think of it this way, if we find what we're looking for, we can go mode Fortress. We already have boss key. Of course, it's not very likely. But it's possible. Okay. We still need boots for a graveyard, though. So I'm not gonna worry about graveyard yet. That's something to, like, keep in the back of my mind, is that graveyard could potentially be, like, war sword or something. Alright, so we're going Fortress. The one good thing about going here earlier is now all of the shortcuts are unlocked, so we don't have to do too much stuff here. We just have to go straight to the dungeon. We are gonna have to do this Armos, unfortunately. So the big thing we're going to do here is we're going to get all of these mids lock checks, like, right away. Or at least a few of them. I'll do like one side, and then I will... I will probably do the boss after that. I think after this one, we're done on this side. Yeah, we're done here. So yeah, we're gonna go straight to boss. Let me get the one thing over here. I don't know what it was. I couldn't see what it was. It's just a vomiting pill, okay. At this point, I'm pretty sure Mazal is going to have a small key. A three. Alright, good start. Bad rolling, but a good pillar to start with. So we don't want to go bottom left. So we'll go this way. Oh, good start. Very good. The bottom left, bottom right. We're gonna hope for another bottom. Oh, perfect. Perfect RNG there. That's just a rupee. Get our third element. Gonna go back in. There are a few more checks we need to get. Though honestly, I think only one of them is a thing. I think everything else is our keys. Can I even? I can't even continue. Yeah, I can't continue. All right, we're done here then. So now, what mist chests do we want to go for? Town mits is a big one. That lets me get center pillar, and I'm gonna get under school. We'll be able to combine these two together very easily. Alright, neither of them were anything. We're still working on mids chests at this point. Mids are our current progression. Possibly shield. Now that I'm thinking about it. Mids or shield. Thank you. So I think we'll try Mitz at Lower Vale Falls real quick. Because now we also have flippers, so I can get this check too. And then maybe we'll do Upper Vale Falls Mitz as well. There's not a ton of places that we can do things. I could also go back up to Cloud Tops. Which is actually going to be the best play. Yeah, we're going back up. I think it's faster for me to do this. Now, do I clean up Cloud Tops first? I think I activate the Wind Crest first. I think it's better to activate the Wind Crest. We're not gonna go and do these checks in Cloud Tops until later. Because right now, we can do Palace. We can do our last dungeon that we need to do. So there's no point putting that off. Like right now, we are just looking for Force Sword. Now is Greggle 2 going to have the Four Sword? No. Four Sworded Palace might be the funniest thing if that happens. Oh, get away from me, dude. Get away. Thank you. early boss key. That's very nice. Except we're still looking for a four sword. So that is not very nice. Karlov metal. Okay. Karlov metal's interesting. I have like a really, really cool idea. It's gonna depend a little bit on what we end up finding over these next few things. Alright, let's not skip hot push. Okay, we could have skipped Pop Push. But if you're looking for an item, I do not suggest skipping Pop Push. I do not have boots, so this is basically done for. Oh no, I have to go to the cloud on the first one, I think. That's nothing. That's a key, okay. All I've got to go for it. Alright, so that was nothing. That was nothing, okay. So here's where my thing is gonna happen. So I'm immediately going to check Karlov Metal. And if Karlov Metal does not pay off, then we go back to the dungeon. And we finish the dungeon. The reason I went for Karlov Metal immediately is because, well, it's four items. Very quick. Very quick items. The fact that no one has finished yet kind of tells me that everyone's looking for this four sword. So it's gotta be in a dumb spot. still not finding anything. Alright, so that is all the keys here. We do still have a few checks we have to do. So there's still some items in here. Pretty sure there's fairies here. Or lots of hearts, yeah. There's a fairy. So there's one more chest here, and then we've gotta go. Okay. There we go. Okay. I counted wrong. So there's one more chest, and then we've got the boss. And after that we gotta start doing like random checks. Random like overworld checks. Do I have down thrust? I don't know if I have down thrust. Guess we'll find out. I do. Okay, that's good. Down thrust really makes this fight so much better. I'm thinking maybe we check those cloud top spots now, like while we're in cloud tops. Boots! Oh, I think we start checking boot spots. Oh man, we check boot spots now, definitely. What's the best boot spots? Oh, I know where to check. I know exactly where to check. It's the graveyard. Hundred % the graveyard. There's just too many things locked behind boots over here. It's gotta be over here, right? The final book. Oh, wait a second. Yolari wants to come out and play. But I think we gotta do graveyard first. 100% we finish graveyard. There it is. Okay. We are done, dude. And this is actually like a good spot. Alright, Dark Hyrule Castle. We just need to find that boss key. We need boss key and at least one small key. This could be a fairly good time. It's gonna depend on how this DHC is. But I think it could still be pretty good. So the one good thing about DHC now is the boss key is randomized. So with the boss key being randomized, that means we could beat this really quickly. Or it could, you know, take the normal amount of time. I'm not even gonna bother with bomb strats here. Cause it's not faster if you have to change and everything. Like if you have to like change your bombs and equip them and all that fun stuff, it's not faster. It's just faster to go for it. Three small keys. Hopefully the boss key is not locked on a tower. Like at this point, I don't even care if the boss key is vanilla, because we already have like most of the keys. All right, let this be a boss key. Let this just be the boss key. Actually, I'm gonna need arrows because I don't have the level 2 boomerang. If I had level 2 boomerang, I could do that. But I don't, so. So we are going to have to go to the towers. We're not going to be able to just go straight to body. Just a little unfortunate, but it is what it is. Let's do that again. There we go. Now with this new meta, I'm not sure what the best tower route is. I think it's probably still okay doing this tower first. Just because this is like the tower I'm used to doing first. Of course, it's the last one. Now we got a map. Okay. This is the fastest tower by far. So ideally it's gonna be here. Nope, okay. It's gonna be the last one that I do, isn't it? Or it's gonna be vanilla. It's gonna be vanilla. There it is, okay. So there is our boss key. We are officially about to go fight Vati. Gonna finish this off as quickly as we can. Because no one else has finished yet. Alright, we're good. Alright, body time. Nice three cycle, let's go! Body is getting into a very weird position here. It's fine. I don't like this position. There we go. Okay. Good three cycle. Good body fight so far. Not gonna YOLO it. Good position. I'll take it. Bad phase. Not supposed to do that, dude. Alright, that's it. GG. Finishing in first place with an official racetime.gg time of 2 hours, 30 minutes, and 37 seconds. What a race. That was a good race. I definitely think some of like my early plays helped me out a lot. Like doing Librari, doing chickens, doing Simon, like all these things that are generally awful checks ended up having things that we needed. Take a look at the stats.